You think tough kids caught up in the street wars cannot be salvaged. You haven't met Darren Howell.
When I was younger, I was asked, like most children, what I wanted to be when I grew up. I would always say my life's goal was to be alive by the time I was 21.
From the age of 11 until he was 21, Darren carried a gun for protection.
I wanted a certain identity and reputation, along with some memorable experiences. I got exactly what I wanted, at a price that would cost me missing my daughter's birth and my sister's passing.
I made poor decisions in the year of 2003, which led to my incarceration from September 03 to September 04.
Darren had been fired from his first job after jail because a Corey check revealed his criminal record. But Turner was convinced after meeting Darren that he was bright, motivated, and sincere.
Come on. City Council, nobody thinks City Council is going to personally, you know, come into their living environment and actually help them. But he did. And I mean, that's like a blessing from God in itself.
I think what saved me was a determination that I knew there had to be a way out, but I just didn't know where it was. I wanted to know that I tried, and so that was my motivation. From then I became active, locally and nationally, in the fight against social injustice and economic inequality, which inspired me to run for elected office.
Today, Darren Howell is working ceaselessly at City Hall and in the neighborhoods to help reduce the bloodshed in Boston.
So when they see me coming daily through with a suit and a shirt and a tie, they say, "That's that guy that was in a cell 5 years ago. That's that guy that was on a block 3 years ago. Now that's the guy up in City Hall trying to fight for me. He's coming to court for me."
Today, I know I will be there to watch my children grow and that my work impacts millions of people in a positive way.
Darren Howell says this is the ultimate motivation for wanting to stop the madness. A safer future for his 8-year-old stepson, JJ, and his twin daughters, Maya and Anaya.
It's better to be this type of image for him, to look up and say, "Hey, that's my dad. My dad's doing something different than what everybody else is doing." And that's the legacy I want them to have.
Looking back to 10 years ago, I had narrow, almost non-existing opportunities. Now all the doors are open, be it through political, through labor, or even grassroots. I don't know what the future holds, but I know that with the continued support of my community and family, I will continue to create a way out of no way for those following in my footsteps.
So that type of ability to do that, anyone can gain. When I look at my Corey from 5, 6 years ago and I see assault with intent to murder, gun possession charges, drug trafficking, assault by means of a dangerous weapon, I look at that all acquired in 1 year of making poor decisions and how they stacked the deck against me. And I said, "No, I'm going to stack the deck against you by getting that population of people to wake up and to be a part of this movement, because if they're a part of this movement, it's a powerful change."